Hi there. I'm coming to you from a marina near Derby in the UK, where I'm leaving my narrowboat to travel to Budapest for a coach. Anyway, we're coming to the end of August, which means we're coming to the end of our SAP Developer Challenge on APIs. We hope you've had a good time with all the tasks. You've been absolutely fantastic during this month. Loads of interaction, loads of replies, comments, questions, answers, discussions. That's what we love to see. We're going to leave the challenge open for a few more days over this weekend to give you a chance to catch up on any tasks you still want to do. And then we'll announce the stats and those who've got badges and so on. Next week is the start of the September SAP Developer Challenge. And September's SAP Developer Challenge is going to be on the topic of full stack development with SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, that's CAP to you and me, and SAP Fiori. Look out for a blog post that's going to be published next week announcing and describing this task. The blog post is going to be from our developer advocate, Dina. So watch this space and I'll see you online.
It's SAP TechEd season and I'm beyond excited to see our amazing community come together this November. Whether you're joining us in Bangalore or virtually from around the globe, I know you'll leave SAP TechEd with more knowledge and skills to tackle new projects. Learn about the latest product innovations, interact with SAP experts, and hear directly from our vast ecosystem of customers and partners. With two full days of live programming and a full deck of interactive sessions, this is your chance to explore real-world questions with our diverse community of thought leaders, trailblazers, and peers. Keynotes, strategy talks, hands-on workshops, lectures, demo sessions, you name it, we've got it. You can expect to learn more about Gen AI and how to use it in a business context, the best approach to move to the cloud, and how SAP BTP can unlock developer productivity via low-code and pro-code tooling. If you're joining virtually and want a hands-on experience, don't miss our new Jumpstart sessions. So register today for SAP TechEd and clear your calendar. See you in November.
Hey there, I'm back again with some news items related to ABAP Cloud. First in my list is SAP System Hibernation for SAP BTP ABAP Environment aka Steampunk, which is available since 28th of August. With this, free tier systems will be stopped each night automatically by SAP operations and need to be started manually by the customer before the next usage. A significant advantage of this feature is that it allows you to stop and restart the system without deleting the associated SAP HANA Cloud instance, and hence it is cost effective. A technical prerequisite for using this new feature is migrating the service plan 16 ABAP 64 DB to the standard plan, as highlighted by Sheena in one of the previous SAP developer news. This migration is necessary to leverage the planned system hibernation feature effectively. Frank Yen's blog post addresses some of the frequently asked questions, including the potential impact on cost and the process of starting and stopping the system. To benefit from the intended cost savings, we recommend planning a potential usage and to fulfill the prerequisites. Kindly check out the blog post and remember to start the steampunk system before using it. Next in the list is Clean ABAP ATC Checks aka CodePal for Cloud Edition. CodePal is a project that provides ATC checks to assist ABAP programmers in adhering to Clean ABAP Style Guide, which encompasses best practices and enforce set of rules for you as developers to write high quality code that is easier to understand and work with it. Initially, the legacy version of the clean code check for ABAP was available as a basis 740. However, with the introduction of the new version of the project, these checks can now be executed in the ABAP cloud environment as well. This expansion provides developers using the ABAP cloud environment with the same benefits of code quality and consistency that were available for on-premise developers. The project's GitHub repository contains detailed information about the requirements, setup, and instructions. Additionally, since this project is open source, contributions from the community are encouraged to enhance and improve it further. The last news item is Cecilia Scalar Functions in the release of SAP BTP ABAP Environment 2308. This feature empowers developers to define their own custom functions directly on the SAP HANA database using SQL script and then reuse them in CDS view entities. There are two types of scalar functions mentioned: analytical scalar function, which are designed and implemented by SAP, and SQL-based scalar functions, which can be defined and implemented by customers and partners. The SQL-based scalar functions make user-defined AMDP scalar functions known to the ABAP dictionary and available in ABAP CDS. Complex calculations now can be outsourced from single CDS entity and still be pushed down to the HANA engine. In this blog post, Andrea provides examples to illustrate the process of creating a CDS SQL-based scalar function. The post also contains a short video explaining the three key development objects of a SQL-based scalar function, its syntax, and how it can be used within a CDS view. Kindly go through the blog post to get the complete technical details of CDS scalar functions. You can find all the link to all the said blog posts so far in the description below. Kindly check it out.
Hello everyone, the SAP TechEd is back again. Please mark your calendars for 2nd and 3rd of November. Join to connect directly with SAP experts, industry influencers, and our vast developer and IT practitioner community. You have the opportunity to learn the latest technologies and the best practices to ensure that you have the skills to stay relevant and the knowledge to remain one step ahead. We have the executive keynotes, hands-on workshops, show floor, demo sessions, and more. Don't miss the developer keynotes. And please do visit the developer garage, where you can meet most of the SAP developer advocates in person. The primary in-person SAP TechEd event will happen in Bangalore, India. If you are not able to join this in-person event, you can join SAP TechEd virtual event. SAP and partner communities will also host in-person watch and code parties in the select global cities and the time zones. Please check the TechEd virtual page for more details. The registration for SAP TechEd is now open. You can find the link for the SAP TechEd registration and community group in the description below. See you then at SAP TechEd.